I took a picture of just about everything over at the house. Well, everything, really. Except for the smokehouse. Dogs, cats, people. I took a picture of my granny, my horse. My granny's a swinging axe.
Why were you taking that picture?
You told me to.
All of the black and white photographs in this presentation were selected from the work of 150 children between the ages of 6 and 14. They live in the mountains of southeastern Kentucky. The pictures were taken using inexpensive Polaroid and Instamatic type cameras as part of a special class in 3 public schools over a 5-year period. Their teacher was photographer Wendy Ewald.
There are 2 kinds of purposes for this, and one is that the pictures end up in family albums and on walls and as part of a family record. And then doing an exhibit like for the Smithsonian, I see is totally different. That becomes something for other people to see, a presentation of a way of life and a way of thinking and a way of seeing.
I got 9 chickens, 3 ducks, a rabbit, and a dog, and a cat. I eat the store's chickens, not my chickens. I don't like to eat my own chickens.
Have you ever killed an animal?
No, I've never killed an animal or eat a wild, dry land animal. I've seen a hog being killed, and they shot it in the head. They heat the water, then pour it over it and scrape the hide off of it with a knife. When you raise it yourself, and you might see you know it. Well, if it left me, I'd just eat vegetables.
Pretty nice set of lungs, then.
Yeah. I could use mom's room.
Where are you going to put this old head in?
Right in this bucket. I already got some water in it, too. Now, where's the apple job in his mouth?
The first thing they did was to do self-portraits, which, you know, at first they said, oh, I can't do that. I can't take a picture of yourself. And then by understanding that, yes, you could hold the camera in front of your face and you could act out something that you wanted to and have somebody else take the picture, that then they could be in their own pictures, which I think, you know, is something that kids really want to do. I mean, the idea of taking pictures of other people is nice, but also, you know, you want to be able to have pictures of yourself doing the things that you think are important or cool or whatever.
What do you like about taking pictures of yourself?
Huh? Me?
Yeah.
Of myself?
Yeah. Why do you like doing it?
Just like. Just to be doing. When I ain't got nothing else to do. I just hopped up there and jumped on the horse. That's how Jim Lee is. Everybody thought that was a couch.
A couch?
Mm-hmm. Oh. They thought it's some couch. Huh. And I was on the back of it. One person thought it was a goat. I let my sister take it. When I got on the horse, I told her to scoot back because she couldn't get me off. My uncle, he's been talking about trading him in and getting a mew.
What do you think of
it? No mew. Because mews kick.
I think any time that you're allowed to see something from the inside, I think it's really revealing. And the thing that most amazed me was the things that the kids would try. They weren't just pictures identifying things in their lives, but they would actually make things happen to photograph or find these different moments that revealed something about the people.
See, the music was in that basement, and this girl, Michelle, I told her how far to get away. I told her to take the picture when I said when. And I was supposed to be in dance.
Do you like that picture?
No.
No?
I look terrible in it.
Do you think there's anything special about families in the mountains?
Yeah. I guess you get along better.
What's your father look like?
I don't know how to describe him. Old, mostly.
How about your mother?
Mm-hmm. Big and round.
How do I describe my family?
To me, they're nice. And they'll do about anything for you if they can. They try to figure out how to save a little money. They must worry about it after me and Tom's asleep, because they don't ever hardly talk about it. We manage anyhow.
Chop wood and get in coal, fix the drain pipes and all that junk.
What'd your father do?
He used to work to come up coal mines till he caught black lung. That's that coal dust and rock dust in his lungs, you know, formed the hard stuff.
Daddy worked 10 or 15 years in the mines. I don't want to ever do that. I've heard a lot of people getting killed. Grandpa worked in the mines. Big rock fell and broke his back.
What do you imagine it to be like?
Big dark hole. Nothing but black and motors running. People hammering, rolling, and everything. All kind of noise. You can take a picture of somebody and a year later they'll be dead and you go find a picture.
Your foundation, the only thing that he asks a man is to build upon that wherein that is all already laid. Oh, then I'll give unto them a little white stone. Oh, and in that stone a new name written, brother, wherein that no man knows him, and he that receive it. Oh, when you've got that stone, you've got Jesus down in your heart, down in your soul, and your name is written in the Lamb's book of life.
In the mountains, that's where I want to be. It's more funner. I like the city, but there's too many noises. Well, city noises. You don't hear hoot owls.
Ah!
city's got just about everything concrete. They ain't got many trees. Yeah, and I like to go up in the mountains sometimes, hunt rabbits, groundhogs, make them as a pet. Maybe turn them loose when they got big, if there's a baby. I don't know, I guess I'm just a hillbilly.
You think it's gonna be very different when you grow up?
Yeah. Probably new bridges, new houses, new stores. I don't want to, but they ain't my mountains.
At one point, asked them to photograph their dreams, trying to get them to see that they weren't limited by what they saw. We talked a lot about what dreams are and what are the things that they dreamed about, and that dreams aren't necessarily sleeping dreams, but they're things that you fantasize and things that you make up, and then things that they act out when they were playing.
What do you dream about?
Houses, the way I'm gonna live after I get married, mountains.
My granny, I can remember when I was little, she said the tree's eyes were on their branches, at the end of their branches, were all kinds of eyes. I was a tree one time. I was the biggest tree in the world. Every kind of bird in the world was on me. In the wintertime, I stayed warm and birds stayed inside.
Do you like to imagine things?
Yep.
What do you like about it?
'Cause it seems real.
You think your mother still has her dreams?
Yeah, but she says she don't have good dreams no more.
Do you want to grow up, be an adult?
Nope, not really. When I get big, might sound stupid, but I still want to just sit around and imagine all my life.
Do you dream a lot?
Yeah.
What kinds of dreams do you have?
Most about graveyards, something like that.
You like your dreams?
No, they scared me.
What do you think dreams are?
Something that's in your conscience. Sometimes to tell you what's gonna happen.
Did you ever dream anything that came true?
Yeah, I dreamed this baby died and one of its eyes was open. And then the next day this baby died with leukemia and what they said one of its eyes was open.
How'd you feel?
Scared, was afraid I'd have another dream.
Tell me about these pictures. What's the story behind them?
See, he had this brother, this twin brother of his, and he went to the place he died, and he saw his brother floating in the air. And then he had to kill him again with a stake. Well, that was his mom or somebody dead, and he was praying to him to help him. And I put sticks over him like it was a house, falling on him, and then I told him that just act like he's dead, you know. And he'd grin, and I had to make him stop grinning. And I told him that if he didn't act like he's dead, I wouldn't take the picture.
Do you like these pictures?
Yeah, they're scary. If I didn't know how I took the pictures, I mean,